Hi guys, welcome to another video. So in today's video I'm gonna show you how can you export your texture map from Substance and set in Marmoset and render it out. So let's get started. First of all, what you gonna do, open your Substance file which you texture out and hopefully you complete it. So how you can export your texture? There's two ways. One, go to file and export texture, and second, you can press the shortcut, that is Control Shift N E. Okay, so now we have our four UV set which we work on it. Bottom, ground, mid and top, I name it out. So open once again and check all the maps which you gonna need, and we render it down in Marmoset. So that you know, Marmoset is a small gaming engine. So gaming engine we export in Unreal Engine. So you can easily find Unreal Engine. There is Unreal Engine 4 packed, and just choose your location, maps, select and just export it. So I exported in Targa format. If you want, you can also export in JPEG and all, but Targa gives you the best result for gaming purpose. So best to choose Targa and set the resolution in 4K. All my maps are exported and we are in Marmoset tool bag. So you can see I already imported my mesh. So let's get started with our texture. So first of all, I just reduce my light so I can work it better. So what you gonna do, firstly create four new materials. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and name it. Top, mid, bottom and ground. Okay, and apply these materials to your geometry. So top, just drag and drop top, mid, bottom and this one is ground. Okay, so we're gonna start in top part. So click your top material and just apply your exported texture. So I just open top base color, so you can see how it's gonna look. So this is my base color and this is my normal and this is my roughness metallic and occlusion map which Unreal gonna use like this, and Marmoset also can use it. So just base color going to albedo map, normal map going to normal map, and just flip the y-axis, and now the main map roughness, metalness, and enable the occlusion, and now it's very dull and not reflective anymore. So we're gonna change some channel information. So in roughness channel we're gonna put G, and metalness we wanna put B. So it's like R G B. Alright. Okay, now it's look. Okay, now you think where is all the opacity gone, right? So go to the transparency and click dither, and you can see the opacity is still on. And don't worry if you don't see all your opacity, if we change our sky you can see it then better. So we can do it later. All my materials are set. So now we gonna do some lighting and render it out. Okay, just close it and put some lights. We are simply do a 3-point lighting. So just set one light here and make the opacity around this. This look nice. Now copy this light, or you can add another light. This second light. And just decrease a little bit light. And place our final light. Control D again. And this is my rim light. So increase the intensity. Okay, now you can play with the color. So I'll just give it some warmish color. This I choose some cool color. And for the extra details, what you can do, play with sky. So you can play with different environments, and which suits you best you can go for it. So I think I like this. It blend with my model. And if you don't see the blurry background, you can go for the flat color. Can also be a very good effect, and go with a darkish color. Okay, so I think I just blur it out some this sharp line. Okay, now you can also play with some camera effects. So if you want, you can play with exposure contrast, but I can do it in Photoshop. So play with little bit bloom. It can enhance your render. And vignette is a really good now go to render and on the global illumination and ambient occlusion, and you almost done. Now you can just tweak little bit lighting and all, and you are good to go. And there are results you will get. So you can just tweak a little bit in Photoshop, and now you are good to go with your lovely full render. So hope guys this video will help you. So if you have any questions, comment down below, and please subscribe to my channel for this one, for this kind of videos. So thank you. See you in next video. Take care.